Dave's Bacon Egg. But the minimum wage law, any kind of minimum or any kind of regulation on prices, it discriminates against less preferred people. Mm. I mean, if you ask the question, and one example I frequently give talking about setting prices, any kind of price control, it discriminates against less preferred people. I often ask people, suppose you saw a fat, old, ugly, cigar-smoking man, and he's married to a beautiful young lady. What kind of prediction would you make about that man's income? You would guess that it's pretty high. And what is he doing? He's telling the beautiful young lady, look, I can't compete for your hand on the basis of a guy like Williams, so I'm going to offset my handicap by offering you a higher price. And so decent people might say, well, gee, is it fair for beautiful young ladies to treat fat, old, ugly, cigar-smoking men any differently than they treat handsome men? And they'll say no. And then you make a law saying that that beautiful young ladies can't charge fat, old, ugly, cigar-smoking men higher prices than they charge handsome men. Then you say, well, then what happens to the probability of a fat, old, ugly, cigar-smoking man marrying a beautiful young lady? What you've done by regulating prices, you've taken away his most effective means of competing with the more preferred man by offering higher prices. And so that's the same thing when you regulate any price. You handicap less preferred people.
So if